अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिजे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीना अपराधलक्ष्मी क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदो तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुतोष्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणान्तिके। माई हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माई स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाद श्रीमद्भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज एंड सेम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माई शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाद श्रीमद्भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज। आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू वेस्ट टाइम, यू शुड कम विथ मी वेयर
प्रयाग।
एनी हाउ यू शुड कम इन द मिडल ऑफ Ganges, Jamuna and Saraswati and take bath there three times. Oh, three one, two, three. And then come in the, where?
Council
in the Council of Srila Rupa Goswami, where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching something to them. We have begun from so many days. We have come up to the creeper, bhakti creeper. After Brahmanda, Parabhyam, Birja, Parabhyam, and then Golok Vrindavan. I explained how many branches, five branches there are in Golok Vrindavan. And if five branches, so many upa branches.
Sub-branches,
lakhs and lakhs. Oh, you cannot count. Their fruits are also so sweet. And then the creeper goes where? In the lotus feet of Kalpavriksha, Krishna lotus feet. Kalpavriksha, whatever you want, at once quickly you will have this. Anything you want, like desire tree. But the gardener is here. Where?
In this world.
But you cannot imagine that how he is here. By body you can see here. But his soul?
Yeah.
With creeper. So here, in his body, his high class of association, always hearing, and after hearing he his kirtaning. What he hears? Like what Sukadev Goswami heard from his father repeatedly. And then he did Kirtan in the council of Parikshit Maharaj. And what Suta Goswami heard there from his Gurudev. And he told to all Sonak Sanak, 88,000 of Rishis and Maharshi. And in their line, Madhavendra Puri, and then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and after that Sarup Damodar Raya Ramananda, and after that Rup Sanatan. And in this line, up to now, they are following the same line. So you should try to follow. Practically, sincerely, externally, internally, in all ways. The gardener, they are always hearing. Like how, what? Rup and Sanatan met in Nandagaon. Near Ter Kadamba. And they were hearing and
discussing.
What thing? Sweet pastimes of Krishna. From morning it became 3.
Afternoon.
They forget that very sun. Whether it is hot or
cold.
So observe. Heart melting. Sometimes when they were discussing about the separation mood of Radha and Krishna, or tree even, the leaves, everywhere, all dried and dropped down. Very strange. And when they began to describe their meetings, Sambhog Leela, how they are smiling, making each other smiling. As you heard, Krishna is madhur. His Radha is madhur. His all gopis are madhur. His crooked glands are so madhur, sweet. Even his jasti, you know?
Stick,
crooked and very madhur. His mother is madhur, his father is madhur, his friends are madhur. Gopis are madhur, cows are madhur. Yamuna. Oh, his Vrindavan is madhur. Oh, Mathura is madhura. Everything. You cannot imagine from here. If you will attend the association of Rup Sanatan and likewise, you can hear all. Then you will forget. Like they forget sun, very sun, everything.
Leaves are coming.
Ki?
When they need.
Milon and Lila sune gashyaban apna hote notun pata.
Ito to bol. Disturb kar. And when they are speaking about all madhurs, everything is madhura. His Lila madhura, his Venu madhura. His everything is sweet, so sweet, so sweet. And when discussing each other, the trees which were dried at all, and new leaves, reddish, they came again. It seems that they were also hearing. If trees are in this stage, we should try to have like this, that we should forget everything. And new leaves in our manjaris and everything should come, and we should also be madhur, because we will become of Radha Krishna.
Association.
So we should try to know all these things. So even Mali, gardener, is here, but he is testing what?
Fruits there.
There. Sitting here, like here one day, the pastime of Srinivasacharya and
so Ramachandra,
you where he here,
yes.
This one?
Yes.
Like here. Oh, they are sitting here. And where they are?
There.
With creeper. And testing. Like Rupa Goswami. like Sanatana Goswami. Or sitting here, they were chanting, but at once they were absorbed and chanting was there. And they become senseless for this world, but very active for that world. And they are seeing that as if, as a manjari, they are there in the council of gopis with Krishna. Oh, making so many pastimes there. And sometimes, a shadow comes in their body, laughing, sometimes weeping, like this. And this is the state told in Bhagavatam, evam brata sapriyanam akritya jatanurago jitachitta uchyai hasattatho rodati rauti gayat unmadyati nityat lokbhaiya. Sometimes Sukadev Goswami or Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Madhavendra Puripad, all these. Sometimes Narad, what doing? Oh, weeping. Why weeping? Like madmen. Have you heard the Bharat in third life? Or sometimes weeping, sometimes like madmen rolling on the earth. Why? Anyone cannot reply. But those who are like them, they can reply. So they became Mahabhagavat here. But his creeper, Bhakti creeper, where has gone? Oh, Golok Vrindavan. Up to Rati, Bhav, Sadhak body will be here. But that body has changed. All worldly thinkings and everything has gone away. No Vishaya there. Always 24 hours reminding, remembering Krishna, singing Krishna, hearing Krishna. So, they are doing. But when Prem will come, he cannot control his body. Whether their bodies are now pure, but now they will give up when Prem will come. And someone, like Dhruva, became transcendental. They will give up this body here, that no need of taking, that it should be transcendental. There is transcendental inside. Very beautiful. Very beautiful. All having quality. Why to make this body transcendental? Understand by? No need of.
Eternal.
So eternal body will come. And anyhow, alakshit rupena, you cannot see, but they will give up this body and to go Golok Vrindavan. Jadi Vaishno aparad uthe hathi mata upadava chinditar sukh jaya pata. But when he is in this body here, continuing his shravanam kirtanam and all these things, anyhow knowing or unwell, knowingly, especially knowingly, if Vaishnava Parad will come, they will do any offense to Vaishnava. Krishna cannot tolerate. His name cannot tolerate. His Harikatha, they cannot tolerate. His Harikatha, name, Leela, pastimes, all are like Krishna. Don't think that these are quality. They have transcendental shape, vyaktitva,
personality.
They have personality. Bhakti has personality. Shraddha has personality. So if anyone does anything, any offense to Vaishnavas, then what becomes? Quickly Shraddha will go away. When Shraddha, the root will go away, then what will be? फिर ये निष्ठा रुचि आसक्ति अप टू रुचि क्विकली गो एंड देन वी विल बी लाइक जीरो. तिलक में भी देयर, कंठी में भी देयर, बट ग्रेजुअली दे वर आल्सो दे विल आल्सो डिसअपीयर. सो ट्राई टू नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स, डोंट मेक offenses. Even you should not criticize them. If any bad person is there, this is not your look after. You should go on.
Not to worry about any bad person.
You should not come in his association. From far away you can do pranam. And you should always observing, chanting, remembering, and all these things. Even what to do offense, it is like mad elephant. It will take the root, from root it will take and
uproot.
Throw it.
Or even you should not neglect. Neglect you should know, mm-hmm. You know.
Neglect any vice.
Don't neglect. If you are neglecting, so neglecting one time, two time, and then it will become offense. If you don't know anything, you are doing some like offense, it will be
sin.
Counted in sin. But repeatedly doing, knowingly, then it will be maha, maha, aparad offense. So if you are doing bhakti even, and you are doing this, very soon your bhakti will go away. So be very careful for this. Even by mind, you should not neglect bhakti, bhagavan,
bhakta,
or anything related to Krishna. Never. Even not neglect. A Vaishnava is coming, and you went by this. What is this nonsense?
You are not happy.
You are not happy. Then it is like offense, this neglecting also. What is the meaning of upade? Vachinde tar sukhi jaye pata. If it is very heavy offense, then it will uproot it. Or chinde, if it is not so much, he takes only, not uproots. What is?
Breaks in the
breaks
middle.
The leaves, something. That creeper also. And all the leaves will dry. So be careful. A Vaishnava has come to any nearby. And he heard that he is high class of Vaishnava. But he could not go there. Knowingly. I know all. Then this is negligence. Then it will take so many leaves and it will break. Not uproot. And if he is attending again with honor or association going. And repent for this that I have done this. Then bhakti may come. Understand the second?
Yeah.
What I told?
You said that if you neglect the availability or association of a pure devotee, then it may break the creeper. But later on, if you come back into that association
and repent for this,
repent for not having gone, then you can restore your creeper.
Then again, bhakti may come. So two kinds. Tate mali jatna kari kare abaran aparad haste jeche na hai. So gardener, what he does? He makes a fencing around the
creeper.
So that mad elephant should not come. Any she-goat cannot come, or he-goat. Oh, they are very expert in
taking the leaves.
Oh, there is nothing that goats not taking. Everything they take. So, you should be very careful. What is that fencing?
Yes.
What is that fencing?
Association.
Good association.
Good association. If not good association, even, oh, so many Vaishnava are there. Even they are Kanishta, even you should be in them. They will guard you. Oh, whether he is going to any, huh? Any vidhava?
Widow
or any fair he is going. Then he will fear. This is like a fencing. And if Vaishnava, always in association, oh, it is concrete fencing.
Wall.
No? So we should try to have be in this way. Sometimes any devotee may be weak. At once he should, anyhow, he should try to go very soon in the association of high class or Gurudev. And open his heart. He should. Like book, open book. Gurudev, read this. O Vaishnava Guru, my Shiksha Guru, you should read. And he will hear all this and obey. Not only hearing will do, but you should obey them. Kintu, jadi latar sanga uthe upasakha, bhukti mukti bancha jato asankhatar lekha. निषिद्धाचार कुटिनाटी जीव हिंसन लाभ पूजा प्रतिष्ठा आदि जत उपासन शेख जल पाइया उपशाखा बढ़ी जाएगी स्तब्धैया मूल शाखा बढ़ते हैं. यू हैव मीनिंग ऑफ स्वामी जी? एनी परपर्ट? नो, बट यू शुड रीड द मीनिंग. यू शुड थिंक दैट ऑफ माय गुरुदेव इज इंस्ट्रक्टिंग स्पीकिंग ऑल. And you should try to follow.
Sometimes unwanted creepers, such as the creepers of desires for material enjoyment and liberation from the material world, grow along with the creeper of devotional service. The varieties of such unwanted creepers are unlimited. Some unnecessary creepers growing with the bhakti creeper are the creepers of behavior unacceptable for those trying to attain perfection, diplomatic behavior, animal killing, mundane profiteering, mundane adoration, and mundane importance. All these are unwanted creepers. Purport by Srila Prabhupada.
Very big.
It's a couple of paragraphs.
Couple of paragraphs.
Not so big.
So big.
Yeah.
But Parpat has come. Achata, you, in brief.
There is a certain pattern of behavior prescribed for those actually trying to become perfect. In our Krishna consciousness movement, we advise our students not to eat meat, not to gamble, to engage in illicit sex, and not to indulge in intoxication. People who indulge in these activities can never become perfect. Kutinati, or diplomatic behavior, cannot satisfy the Atma, the soul. It cannot even satisfy the body or the mind. The culprit mind is always suspicious. Therefore, our dealings should always be straightforward and approved by Vedic authorities. If we treat people with diplomatic or duplicitous behavior, our spiritual advancement is obstructed. Jiva Hinsa refers to the killing of animals or to envy other living entities. The killing of poor animals is undoubtedly due to envy of those animals. The human form is meant for the understanding of Krishna consciousness, Ato Brahma Jigyasa. Then it goes on for you.
There is some deeper meaning and deepest. Deepest. So much. It can be explained for 2, 3, 4 days, no harm. So deep meanings are here. You know, what is Upashakha?
Sub-branch in
desire, the
sakha.
What is upashakha?
It's a branch that, it's a plant that looks like the creeper. It has some of the symptoms, but it's actually a weed that will strangle the creeper.
You should know that there are two kinds of upshakha, sub-branches. One in tree, and one out of tree, nearby growing, or seems to like similar creeper, but not really that creeper. Looks it like may be useless any creeper. Understand? And some, or very beginning in from the root of that creeper, so many branches, sub branches are coming on. Here it has been given that Nishiddhachar, Kutinati Jivhinsam. These are the other creepers which are growing around that creeper, but not same creeper, in same creeper. No? Mm-hmm. Like there is a paddy
field.
Paddy field. Creeper. Field. Creeper or that.
Plant.
And so many kinds of
weeds.
Around, it seems that same thing. But they have no grain. But like same. But no grain at all. So they are called upashakha. If you are giving water and all these things, oh, they will grow up and they will cover the main
creeper.
So that are nishiddhachar. You are doing bhakti even. But you are doing what Nishiddhachar, which has been
prohibited in scripture
not to do.
Forbidden activities.
Huh?
Forbidden activities.
Forbidden activities. What is that? Govinda Bhakat. What may be that? Don't go to bad association. Don't drink. Don't smoke.
Don't gambling.
Don't gamble. Like these things. They are separate from bhakti. But if they are, and you are hearing, oh, all the fruits will go there, water will go there.
Nourishment.
And by this, oh, you'll have name and fame, then all will come to you. Even you are drinking, doing so many nonsense. I know so many acharyas now, so-called guru, here and there. They are doing nonsense. But even they have thousand and thousand of disciples. A guru, from his sannyas, he was deviated. But the blind followers of that guru, even with them, with his guru, and thinking that, oh, he has been liberated person, and he's so high, more than gopis and gopis. They think, what to do? So these are Nishiddhachars. We should try to know all these things. Kutinati. Kutinati. Ku. Those are very bad things. Very bad things. You should not do. But you are doing same. And nati.
Forbidden
things. Forbidden things. Like jivahinsa. Jivahinsa means?
Violence.
To kill, violence.
To kill
animals.
Even like what? Sweet madhu.
Honey from beehive.
But others. Don't be like monkeys. Don't kill any animal. Like there was a person like this. And he met
Naradrishi.
Naradrishi told, why you are killing all the animals? Why not just killing? And you are keeping them alive, but they are doing
restless. Feeling so much
half
pain.
Killing.
Half killing. You hide. Oh, I have a taste.
To see
I feel pleasure in doing this. Oh, you feel. And he took some water and sprinkled. And he saw that all lakhs and lakhs, all they came to whom he has killed. And they are killing one by one. And they were row in row of thousands.
Waiting.
They will
kill him.
Kill him. So he became senseless. Again he took some water and sprinkled. Oh Gurudev, I have realized now. Oh, please initiate me. I will obey you. Then he told, oh, you should do this mantra. And I'm coming after some time. And you should not go from here. All maintenance will come to you. Don't worry for that. Very soon I am coming. You should chant and remember this mantra. And he went away. And after 1 year, 2 years, he returned. And this bogus word,
hunter
was changed.
Completely changed.
When he saw from far away that his Gurudev is coming, oh, he wanted to do pranam, but he could not do. Why? So many ants, so many
insects
were there. So he took his chadar and
wiped away carefully.
Carefully, that they should not
be heard.
And then he did pranam. Then Angira Rishi asked, oh, my friend Narad, who is that person? Even he is doing pranam, but very carefully, taking care of the insects and
ants.
Oh, he told that. He was a big, very
cruel
hearted hunter.
But he met me and I told to follow me. And now he is following. Okay. Oh, I know. You are like desert tree. Or what?
Touch a stone.
Whom you will touch, he will be like you. So we should try to remember all these things and be very like this. So if he will giving waterizing, hearing, chanting, remembering, but doing all these things, nonsense, kuti, nati, jivhinsa and all, then bhakti will not come. Never he will come. Your field is not fertile or very bogus, like desert.
Barren land.
And what is lab puja pratishtha? In that creeper, in the root,
sub branches
has come out. Like, have you seen the creeper of Loki? Loki, you know? What Loki?
Gold, pumpkin.
Pumpkin. It goes very high and very.
Many vines.
Many branches.
Branches and many fruits coming. But from the beginning, or in the root, there will come so many. What is the meaning?
Desire for worship.
That is, if you are doing bhakti, but you want what? Lab, puja, pratishtha.
Name, fame.
Adoration.
So what they are?
Upasaka
means ki bhakti, swarup siddha.
Arop siddha bhakti.
Arop siddha bhakti they are. Not really bhakti. You should try to realize the differences between
Arop
Siddha, Sang Siddha and Sarup Siddha. I have told so many times. Do you remember? Arop Siddha, not bhakti. But even you think that, oh, it is bhakti. Like, making garden. You are thinking that all fruits will come and I will serve Krishna. But this is gardening is not bhakti. Why not chanting and remembering? Why you are wasting your time in this? So we should think. And then when you will have all the qualities. Oh, you will cut out the upasakha, grace value. What are they? Oh, I should be happy in this world. Oh, all should
worship me.
Praise me.
Mukti even, liberation. Even the bhakti of Narayan, Lakshmi in Vaikuntha. Moreover, the bhakti of Ramachandra and bhakti of
Dwarkadhis,
Mathuradhis. You cannot cut, but doing some what?
Trimming.
Screaming.
Oh. Screaming.
Trimming.
Don't cut, but very good. And doing like this. And then, oh, the main root, what? To serve Krishna conjugal. All this will go to Vrindavan. Otherwise, they stopped in this world, Brahmanda, Viraja, Vaikuntha, anywhere it can be stopped.
In the middle.
So if you want, then cut them. Only one wish will be there. Even you will have to scream now.
Trim.
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 What is spelling?
T-R-I-M. Trim.
Trim.
Trim. Oh. You should come. What?
Trim.
Oh, very good. Dasharas. Vasalyaras even. Sakharas also. And then you will see that they will be helpful for Madhuras. One pointed creeper will be there. But various branches there also. Various. What? Especially 360 kinds of branches will be there. And in them so much, or sub-branches. It will cover Krishna everywhere. Conjugal Radha and Krishna. So sweet. So sweet. So Mali, Mulsa ka bad jabin, prem phal paki pade. So many kinds of fruits. As he is qualified. Shanta, Dasya, Sakya, Vasalya. You know that Shantaras, Dasharas is also various kind. I told yesterday, more than thousands. And in this way, Vasalyaras, or so many of kinds, so many. And then Madhuras, so many of kinds. So now the fruit is there. Very sweet, very fragrant, and very soft also. No
seed.
No seed, no
string,
nothing. Only a rush and rush. And that is Madhur rush. And from there it comes where?
Down to here.
Where there is Mali.
Gardener.
Gardener. And he tests, pulses are coming, fruits are coming there. And he is,
testing.
What is the meaning? What? He is about to have prem. And in practicing rati, bhav, with vibhav, shantik, vyabhichari. He practices, involves all these things. And very sweet, juicy, realized, taste. Oh, it cannot be told by any words. Even by transcendental words, it cannot be told for the devotees for here. Then, a high class of devotee, he will bring that fruit and give to you that, taste how bitter. Then you can realize. Otherwise not. Like here, the sweet sounds of
peacock.
Remembering Krishna. What Krishna is doing? He is dancing and making
play on a
flute. And peacocks are there dancing. And Krishna is with whom? Very dear gopis there. And they are all dancing. And this sweet
peacocks
giving their tails.
Feathers.
Very, very beautiful, with seven colors. What colors? What color?
Rainbow.
Their colors what? Prem, Sneh, Man, Pranay, Bhav, Rag, Anurag. These seven things are there. You cannot imagine. Their colors are there. So varieties of colors there. Anurag. Rag means color. Anurag, again and again. So these are colors. Colors of modes, of prem, so many things. So they remind. And the devotees will what? He hearing this, and they will at once quickly go to that place, and they will join the council of Krishna, where he is dancing and doing all these things. But what is here? This is the stage of Rati. Come, gradually maturing. And Mamata is coming more to Krishna. The devotees who are related with Krishna, Mamata. Mamata means? Oh, Krishna is mine. First it will come. Oh, I am of Krishna. The mood of Chandravalis and others, his followers. And after that it will come. Oh, Krishna is mine. Now Krishna is controlled. And the sadhak becomes in this stage of mood also. Oswadhin Bhartrika, in the guidance of Lalita, Vishakha, all serving conjugal. Oh, you cannot imagine if you are not so much developed. So at the time of Rati, all will come. What is there? You will realize all these things here. And then his bhakti is matured with the help of bhava, vibhava, anubhava, sattvika and all. And gradually, so many transformations are going on. And now he is climbing on that creeper. Gradually. No? He comes out of Brahmanda very quickly from Birja, Brahmalo, Vaikunthalo, then
Ajodhya,
Dwaraka, Mathura, quickly. Oh, he comes to Krishna, Radha and Krishna conjugal. And now he comes in the arms of gopis. As he had endeavored for bhakti and practice. If in Raganuga bhakti he has followed any gopi like Rupmanjari, oh, Dev, he will follow. And she will quickly be merciful to him. And then you will be in Prakat Leela of Krishna, first in the Prakat Leela of Mahaprabhu, and then you will come in the Omb of gopis. And you will be same as you have practiced. And then by the mercy of Nitya Siddha Gopi, Yogmaya, especially Brinda Devi, and then you can serve conjugal in there also that Leela, Aprakat Leela. So this is what? Eita Paramaphal, Param Purusharth. What meaning? Oh, 164.
To taste the fruit of devotional service in Goloka Vrindavan is the highest perfection of life. And in the presence of such perfection, the four material perfections, religion, economic development, sense gratification, and liberation, are very insignificant achievements.
Oh, this is the goal of our life, actually. But we are deficiating. Entangled in lap nishiddhachar kutinati jivhinsan lap puja pratistha. We are entangled. We want to come out. But we think that our atmosphere in which we are, at once we cannot give up. We think that then what to do if I am giving up all these things? How to maintain my life? You don't know that you should not be so much worried for this. Oh, Krishna is there. He has promised. He has promised. So try to follow all these things and very quickly your life will be successful. Go, Prema.
Hare Krishna.
two questions. One, you said if somebody has very bad character, you shouldn't criticize them, but you should not associate. And from very far, you should offer pranams.
Offer pranam means what? Oh, I will not associate. This, not pranam, honorary. It means not. Oh, I will not be with you, no. To avoid.
Then the other question is, you said that if somebody is in Bhava Bhakti, then externally he's hearing and chanting, and internally he's absorbed in Krishna's Leela, and the next verse talks about Vaishnava Parad. So the question is, how can somebody in Bhava Bhakti possibly commit
that Rupa Goswami has showed that he was once in trance, and lame Khanja Krishna Das came, and he unknowingly he laughed for that. But even he thought that, he is laughing to me, and he is somewhat
teasing me.
Eh?
Making fun of me.
Yeah.
Joking.
Mocking.
And by this even, he was disturbed. He was not disturbed, but to show us, to give teachings, that even you should be very careful, very careful. That is. Anything? What?
But why would he talk about Kutinati and those other low activities after speaking about the gardener who's hearing a chant?
Because he in body, that practitioner, Bhakti Yoga. So it may be happen like Bharat. He was doing good for others. He was saving the lives. But this is Kutinati. He should not do like this. If he is drowning, that baby, he has gone there. He must go. If he is thinking that if he was observed in Krishna Lila, he has nothing to do. He will not see. He will never see. And if he has some
outer sense,
then he will see, and that quickly he will take it and keep it and not attached.
When we are not in association of devotees,
not having the shelter of bona fide guru, can we, by reading books, attain any realization on the level of rapi?
Never. It will be that you will not go to hell by hearing and chanting Krishna name. But it may be by the fruit of this, in next birth, you will have a very bona fide guru or siksha guru. And then you will have to go follow same process as it has been told in Shastra. And if you are neglecting that, no need of guru, no need of taking shelter any Vaishnava, what is written I will do, then you will have to go Narak.
If a bhakta have no sense of karta, being a karta, how he can commit a Vaishnava parat?
What? If any Vaishnava is not thinking, I am the doer, how can he commit any aparadhi?
It will be only in prema stage. We are not, up till now, rati. We cannot think like this. Any devotees cannot think like this.
We are karta.
We cannot be on that
still
level.
Are karta.
This question is not
proper.
Something wrong. If he is in this way, in this stage, nothing to think like that. How he will?
Yeah.
It can, a devotee in the stage of nishtha, he can do. Question like this. But after, when ruchi comes, no question like this. Absurd. When nishtha, mani buddhi purvika,
intelligence,
thinks that I should chant name. I have no rati. Even I should chant. I should hear. He has no taste. At that time, these questions comes. But when ruchi is there, no question like this. All doubts gone. If ruchi comes, no doubt at all. No, in any subject, he has no doubt. Only he wants to hear past times. Gaur Praman.
Hari. Hari.
Oh, just to do one kirtan.
Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tada Bhaktaya Namah Bhaktya Vihina Aparadalakshe Chiptasya Kamaditaram Kripamayin Kang Saranam Prapanna Brinde Numaste Yang Prabhrajantamanupetam Apetakrityam Dvaipayano Virakataraya Juha Putreti tanmetaya tarvo bhinedu sam sarvabhotaridayam muni tavai vasmi najivami tvaya vina iti vighe radhi tam nema.
My humble obeisances unto the Lord's feet of my spiritual master, Om Vishnu Pashishmat Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj, and my Shiksha Guru, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. This is our last date here in New Braja of preaching very successful, also distributing so many books, and so many devotees gathered, assembled. I think that what I have told in the line of my Shiksha Guru and my spiritual master both, we should try to follow all these things. You should not neglect all these things. You know, there are two kinds of Guru Parampara. Bhagavat Parampara and Guru Parampara. Srila Prabhupada sometimes rejects bogus Guru Parampara and he admits real Guru Parampara with Bhagavat Parampara. We cannot neglect Guru Parampara, but it should be in the line of Bhagavat Parampara. And I have sought it my book, my Guru Dev biography. I have given all these things very clearly. What Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur wanted to follow. You cannot follow, we cannot follow all Guru Parampara. Never. Why? As if, for example, you can take, Swamiji has initiated more than thousands and thousands of devotees. He has initiated. Or so many
left.
So many divisiated. So many, they are anyhow dragging, anyhow.
Going on,
dragging, sometimes falling down, sometimes anywhere, again coming and going, some. And some are also very strict and sincere, though where they are in householder life or renounce order. I know there are so many sincere Grihastha Vaishnava, householder. They are more sincere than renounce now. So many. They are falling. But so-called gurus are not falling. That is why all are deviating. They are not following the real instructions of Swamiji. What he told everywhere. Everywhere he has told. So sometimes Guru Parampara, a real line of
Bhagavat Parampara.
But in Bhagavat Parampara, Srila Prabhupada accepted one, them who were realized so, not deficiating. Like Bhakti Vinod Thakur, his guru was Bipin Bihari Goswami. But he gave more preference to his Shiksha Guru, Bhagavat Parampara Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. He studied all this from Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, not from
Bipin.
And he has given so much preference to Bhagavat Parampara, Sri Bipin Bihari Goswami. Like Srila Prabhupada. Oh, his guru is Gaurkishore Das Babaji Maharaj in Guru Parampara. And his Shiksha Guru Bhagavat Parampara, he has taken both because both were elevated. So he has accepted by the wish of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur his Bhagavat Parampara Guru, Shiksha Guru, and he has accepted Gaurkishore Das Babaji Maharaj, a high class of elevated, not less than anyone. So here both are
same.
Okay. Here the Guru Parampara and Bhagavat Parampara is like same. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, he took initiation from Madhusudan Babaji Maharaj, a high class of devotee, no doubt. But in Shiksha Parampara, Bhagavat Parampara, Baladev Vidyabhushan and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. Oh, how much elevated, you can see. In same way, we see Shyamananda Prabhu, Hridayananda Prabhu, he was Guru.
Hriday
Chaitanya. He was not deviated. He was
following
in line, but not so much high like Jiva Goswami. So he ordered his disciple all to go there. And there were trained by Bhagavat Parampara, by Jiva Goswami. We have not come to follow the devotees who are not elevated, who are not high. If you will see that we must follow all the disciples of Swamiji, where they are fallen down or not fallen down, or they have been initiated by Swamiji, so they are disciples of Swamiji. So we must follow. Whether they are now Ritvik, where they are what? In line or not line, or following Swamiji or not. Oh, this is bogus idea. You cannot gain anything. You should see that Krishna has given intelligence, using it, and see that who are really in the line of Swamiji. Who is following really? And then come in Bhagavat Parampara. Like Prabhupada told. You should not think about that bogus Guru Parampara there. In Guru Parampara, if a very standard Vaishnava is there, we should follow. We should have honor to him. But they have deviated, not following Swamiji, or proper Guru, then we should not associate with them. So there is some difference and non-difference between Guru Parampara and
Bhagavat.
But always try to give more pressure on Bhagavat Parampara. Bhagavat Parampara cannot be
false.
So you should try to know. We are discussing so much about Rupa Goswami's Shiksha from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jaina Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadam Vayam Dadati Sapadanti. Who is telling this? Narottam Thakur. Was bona fide Vaishnava in Bhagavat Parampara and Guru Parampara both. He is telling, Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jaina. Who established the Manobhisht, desire of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by writing books, by discovering Govindaji, Govinda service, by writing also many books like Bhakti Rasami Sindhu, Ujjwal Ninmani, Vidagdha Madhav, Lalit Madhav, or so many books. What written in these books? What has been written? O Chaitanya Manovishtam. What is that? I have told so much things about this. He was externally Rupa Goswami and internally externally he is serving to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Here externally don't mean that these externals. Oh, with what he was in his body, or with this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And
in this body.
Internally in to Radha Krishna, Jugal in the form of Rupa Manjari. You know that before Rupa Goswami, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given some dream to Tapan Mishra. When he was not renounced and he has went to Purvi Bharat, to
Kasi,
Purvi Bengal, Bengal,
East Bengal.
The, to the
Bangladesh,
where his forefathers have taken birth. And there where he preached and Tapan Mishra came, one very good Brahmin, devotee, he asked that, what is the goal of our life? What is Shadhan Shadhan? And then Mahaprabhu told, you should chant always, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, and all the kinds of Shadhan Shadhan you will receive from that. He was householder, and his son was Gopal Bhatt, Raghunath Bhatt. So he went to Kashi. After that, but I'm going to tell something.
Mahaprabhu ji, Bengal gaye the. Hare Krishna mantra ka upadesh diya tha.
So he, in dream, he saw that he is himself Krishna.
No?
Mahaprabhu. At that time he was not Mahaprabhu, only Nimai Pandit. And then you know that to Rupa Goswami, to Sarvam Bhattacharya, he showed his face like Shadbhuj. First Chaturbhuj and then Shadbhuj. In that, Krishna was there and also Mahaprabhu was there. And also Narayan was, Ram also. The Shadbhuj. Then he showed his Maharasaraj Bhav to Rai Ramananda and prohibited them all, three, that don't declare that I am Krishna. Don't declare. I am Brajanandan Shyam Sundar. Rasaraj Mahabhav. Don't declare. They never declare up till now. Who is the first person who declared vividly in the like drum beating? Who? Sarup Damor also not. Only Rupa Goswami. That first slok was Nandi slok of Vidagdha Madhav. Anarpitacharin Chirat Karunya Vatirna Kalu. Samarapaitam unnatajvalrasaṁ svabhaktesyam harihapūrata-sundara-dyūti-kadambasandīpita sadā-ridaya-kandare-spuratvu-me-sachinandana. Who is Sachinandan? Very Krishna, taking the beauty, golden beauty and entrance of mode. He is like lion. Lion told in this slok, but Sundar Dut Kadamba Sadar Idaye Kandares Purat Me, like for mad elephants, if they know that there is a very strong lion here and they will smell something, and a smell will come from a lion body, and quickly they will.
Say Singh Avasu. Say Singh Avasu Diveta Hridaya Kandare.
So if that lion, who? Or this very lion, Sachinandan Gaurhari, will come in our heart, then all kinds of ignorance and offenses and everything will go. So who is he? Sachinandan. He declared first time that, oh, Sachinandan is himself Krishna, taking the beauty of Srimati Radhika and in turn she moved of Radhika. Or you can tell he is the combined of Srimati Radhika and Krishna, no her. Mahaprabhu told us this. Oh, what you are telling? Your all poems are so high class. But what you did? It means that there is a pot of milk, but you gave some poison. And then all poison. So you, everything is so okay, and why you put this? Then Rai Ramananda told, it is like a very beautiful
condensed milk.
And in this what?
Camphor.
So more.
Tasty and fragrant.
And Mahaprabhu becomes silent. Again, from he took one poem from Lalit Madhav. And again he told like anyone. And Mahaprabhu was very much ashamed that in this big council and he is declaring me, oh, like Krishna and Srimati Radhika. Again he told, why you told? Again he told Rai Ramanand, who was examining Rupa Goswami, that literature. What he proved? Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came? And he has written in his all books, all. He came only, oh, that I have explained so much. He was very kind, so to preach the way process of Rag Marga. Rag Marga. Rag Marga is different from Ragatmik mode. You should try to read all these things, always. Otherwise, I am telling here all these things. And when you will go away from me, and oh, you will forget everything. Then you cannot. Try to engage all times, all these things. I remember one story here, very appropriate for this
occasion.
And what? What? You should always remember this. There was a devotee. Oh, he wanted to read Bhagavatam and went to his Gurudev. And he studied there for some days. And when he finished, he told Gurudev, oh Gurudev, please order me to return back to my home. I want to be renounced. And there I will make any hut and I will chant, remember, and always reading Gita and preaching Gita. Oh, he wanted to keep him in his
association.
And he thought that he will be a great scholar and he will preach my mission. But he was not ready for this. Gurudev, please order me. I should return there. And there I will make hut and I will read and preach there. Or if you like, you may go. And he returned. And what became after that? Stand up. Quickly. In good way. Explaining. Well.
Stand here.
Oh, anyway.
You're all dry cheese, you're all dry cheese.
I don't take time so much in praying.
This is a play that Gurudev has me perform on occasions while we're traveling. What happened after this was that he got his Gurudev's permission. Reluctantly, he and was asking his Gurudev to give him permission to go back to his village where he was born and lived and grew up, and build a small cottage just outside of the outskirts of the village to read his Bhagavad Gita.
Oh, on a very good river.
And
on
beautiful
the
river.
Better, and so much like this.
It's beautiful just like Badger. And as he practiced his bhajan, he had one neighbor living by, and he had a comfortable distance between he and his neighbor. And as he read his Bhagavad Gita, he found that as he read from sloka to sloka, soon parts of his Bhagavad Gita would be missing, chewed away. And he was wondering what was happening. So one day he put his Bhagavad Gita in the middle of the floor and stood and watched and saw a mouse. In the middle of the night, a mouse would come and chew a little bit of the Gita and then run off. So he decided, he was trying to think, what could I do? What could I do to remedy the situation? And rather than approaching an authority, someone who could actually help him, he approached his neighbor. And he walked to his neighbor's house and asked his neighbor, I have a problem. I'm reading my Bhagavad Gita, and this mouse is eating it, and I don't know what to do. So his neighbor said, well, why don't you buy a cat? Because, you know, a cat is a natural enemy of the mouse, and the cat will eat the mouse, and the mouse will eat your Gita, and then it'll be solved. Your problems will all be solved. So he went out and bought a cat. And the cat ate the mouse, and then the cat, what's that?
Go on, go on.
And the cat ate the mouse, and then he thought his problems were solved.
The mouse fled away.
Oh, was fearful.
Oh, okay. Fearful, see. Or never came.
Never came again. Okay. And so then the neighbor had one cat, and the cat lived, and he didn't know how to take care of the cat. The cat became very thin and weak, and soon the cat had no energy, so it just laid around and mewed. And he, again, instead of approaching authorities to deal with the cat, he approached his neighbor again and said, I have a cat who's dying in my house, and I don't know what to do. And his neighbor told him, well, a cat drinks milk, just like your mouse was eating your Gita. Well, cats drink milk, so in order to have nice fresh milk, you have to get a cow. So he went and got a cow, and he was grazing his cow just around his property, and the cow was eating and eating and eating. And pretty soon the cow had eaten up all the fresh grass around, and the cow started getting weak, but the cat was very, very healthy. So instead of approaching authorities, he went to his neighbor again and asked his neighbor, now I have a problem, I have a cow, I have no pasture, my cat, if I don't feed my cow's going to die and my cat's going to die, and the mouse will come back and my Gita will be gone. So he asked his neighbor, and the neighbor said, you know, probably in this circumstances you'd probably want to buy some more property, because if you get some more property, you'll be able to graze your cow further and you'll be able to feed your cat who feeds the mouse, who eats the mouse, who ate your Gita. So he did that. He expanded his land holdings, but he found that he'd have to let the cow out of one pasture and move it to another pasture and take the cow and move it and graze it from place to place so it wouldn't eat all of the grass in one area. And he found it to be too taxing.
Milking.
Yeah, milk. He had to milk the cow and so many new things that he hadn't planned on.
Feed the cow.
Thank you. Feeding the cow. It's something that's important. Well, that's what the pastures were for.
So many other things. Water, etc.
Yes. And by taking the advice of his friend, he didn't foresee a lot of the circumstances which each successive new
situation
would add to his life. So with all these chores and all this work, he did what any intelligent man would do, and he went to his neighbor and he asked, I have a problem with my cow. It's I'm having problems with my chores, and I just have no time to read the Gita anymore. I have no time to study. What do you recommend that I do?
Gurudev was told him to think of him in problem, but he didn't.
What's that?
Gurudev had told, if you're in problem, think of me.
Mm-hmm. And Pundarika Prabhu has reminded me that before he left the ashram as guru, Srila Gurudev told him that if any problems should arise, you just remember me and I'll help you. But at each of these stages of his life, he never thought of his guru. He thought of this friend, this mundane person who just lived next door. So he went to this person and he advised him, well, you know, you should do what most people do when they have too much work to do. And that's probably you should get married, because then your wife could do all the work, and then you could read your Gita all day. So then he thought, that's a great idea. As a matter of fact, it's probably one of the best ideas he'd had the whole time. So he said, as a matter of fact, I know a young girl that's married, has just recently, her father wants her to be married. So he introduced them, and they were very compatible. They had their charts done by a very reputable astrologer. And everything looked great, so they got married. And after some time, the wife was, something was wrong. There was some piece missing. He just couldn't put it together. So he was thinking, you know, what should I do now? I mean, it just seems like I've exhausted all my possibilities. And he didn't remember his Gurudev again. He went to his neighbor. And his neighbor said, you know, it's her biological clock is ticking. Women, they need children, because if they have children, then you can have children, and your children will be able to take up the line, the family line, and they'll be able to do the work. So he figured that was a good idea. So very soon they had many, many children in their home.
How many?
Oh, many. And probably...
Daughters also?
Well, daughters have to be in the picture too. Probably half daughters. Half daughters. So he probably had, like in France, he had about 25 children, I think. And in Holland he had many children. But he couldn't communicate with his children very well. Everything was going downhill. What's that?
Children were in France and Holland. He doesn't know all the languages.
Yeah, he couldn't speak with his kids. So, you know, our kids, they have a language of their own, and it changes all the time. So,
he was thinking that how to marry, to give marriage to all my daughters, two sons, and how to support. Oh, so many problems were there. And he totally forget to read Gita. Mm-hmm. And to even open, he
wrapped
it up and kept
stuck in the rafters.
Oh, yes.
So Guru David mentioned that because he's been taking the help of his neighbor, more and more, his problems increased and increased. He thought he could solve his problems by introducing a solution into his life. The cat, the cow, the lamb, the wife, the children. Things just got more and more complicated. So finally, he and his wife were arguing. He was fighting with his children. The cow was... Everything was just in disarray. So...
Go on.
Okay. And he was... completely overwhelmed. He was never reading his Gita anymore. His Gita had been wrapped up and put up someplace where the kids couldn't get it and nothing could get it. And when he was completely overwhelmed, like an avalanche had fallen on him of all these problems, then he finally, in all of this pain, had called out for his Guru. And just by closing his eyes and thinking of his Gurudev came to him. And his Gurudev said, what is your problem? And he told him about all of his problems step by step, about how he had gotten himself into this mess. And his Gurudev told him, when you were in my ashram, we were studying this Gita together. We were studying the deep philosophical concept contained within the Gita, but I can see by your actions that you didn't learn anything from the things that I taught you. Because had you have absorbed my teachings, you would never have had to have undergone this suffering to learn the lesson that you're learning now. And he said, Gurudev, and he brought his children and his wife and his cow and his cat and his everything and his land. And he said, Gurudev, this is my Gita Sangsar. This is my life. This is what I've culled from my lessons. And it was very, very tragic. And at that point, his guru instilled within him a very, very deep desire to serve Sri Krishna. And at that point, the man, he became so overwhelmed with love of God that everything pulling him and keeping him home, he made up his mind to finally take the lesson of his Gurudev to heart. And he went with his Gurudev and practiced bhajan.
Left everything.
And left everything behind, except for the most important thing.
Thank you. So you should don't make a Gita Sansar.
Huh? World of Gita.
Oh, world of Gita. One after another, he went on going all these things. Now so many children, so many cows, so many bulls. Oh, everything was that very great world. I'm saying same thing.
don't repeat. I know that all were brahmachari nastik at that time, at the time of Swamiji. I know all, top to bottom.
Swamiji
all were.
The same story.
Huh?
Swamiji.
Ramesh was also very strong. But he met some Gita Sansa. So all like this.
Costa Rica.
And there is still saying there, to have cows or daughters, sons, I am following Swamiji. So you should remember all these things. And go on doing. Don't think that I am going. I will be always with you, like that Guru was. Keeping eyes on them, looking on them, what they are doing, and worry for them, how to help them. So always remember this story and try to follow your Gurudev. Then come to subject. Now it is 6:30. Anyhow, how Rupa Goswami established the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? You know, when he was in Jagannath Puri, at the time of Kart festival, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dancing in seven
parties.
Groups, parties, at a time. And who saw this?
Pratap Rudra
and Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, both there. That Mahaprabhu being alone, one, and he's at a time
dancing
there. And what he was doing? Shaita parannath painu jaha lagi madana dhanati. And all that. And in the meantime, he remembered one shlok. Jaha kaumar haram. This is jaha kaumar haram. So this is shlok. Anyone was not understanding that what he was singing. Only one person. And that was who? Sarup Damodar. Only Sarup Damodar. What he is speaking. Otherwise, all were thinking. What this?
Song.
He was singing this song that, I remember my young age. We met in Vrindavan, in Revati, the bank of Revati. A very beautiful garden of Betashi Tarutale. Betashi means?
Cane,
the forest of cane. And it was surrounded by so many kadamba trees. Very big garden of Kadamba. And very sweet fragrance was coming from Kadamba tree. And there was none, only myself and you, my beloved. No Mary, nothing. You are only my beloved. And I was like your beloved. Freely meeting, talking so many things. At that time, we never cared for what our father, mother, or anyone is speaking of. We never cared for anything. And secretly, we used to meet there on the bank of Reva. In the middle of Kadamba trees and Betasu tree, not trees,
cane
like
plant.
Creepers. And very, I remember all this. Now, I have been your wife and you my husband, but I am not so happy in this life. Here there is a relation of
husband and wife.
Husband and wife. That is master and
servant.
Servant. Oh, that rush, mellow is not here now. So I want that we should return to that place on the bank of river or in the Kadamba trees forest, and where the Bethesi or cane tree are there, and we will freely love each other. He was singing Mahaprabhu, and anyone was not following except Sarup Namodar. But a boy nearby that, he was looking very carefully. And he remembered that a slok and went to, after that chariot's festival, he went to take bath in sea. And he wrote a poem like just like Mahaprabhu was telling, uttering. And what was that? Priyo Swayam Krishnaha. And I am the same. And my beloved is same. We used to meet in the bank of Jamuna, under the trees of Tamal and Kadamba. So I want, now you have become, I have come to Kurukshetra, I am meeting you. You are same Krishna, I am same Radha, but I don't want to be here with you. I want that you should come to Vrindavan under the shade of Kadamba trees, Tamal trees, and where bees are humming, cuckoos are
singing,
and peacocks are dancing. I want to meet there. Here, so many horses, elephants, so many army. Chief commanders, army, and so many Bhisham Pitama. His father, Vasudeva, Devaki, and more than 1,108
queens
there. Oh, so many sons and daughters, so many. Also, grandsons also. So here, we cannot meet like that. So I pray that you should come in my heart. My heart is Vrindavan. So please come with us in Vrindavan. He wrote this poem and kept it in the roof of that hut. And he went to take bath in sea. In the meantime, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to give darshan to Haridas Thakur. And he looked and he said, what is this paper? Paper, not paper, but
palm
it
leaves.
Was talpatra.
Palm leaves.
Palm leaves. And he took it. Oh, he saw. Became so happy. Who has written this? Who has written this? Haridas Thakur? Oh, your roof has written. Oh, it was like golden types. So beautiful. All the letters were that Mahaprabhu was attracted. And when he read it, then what became? Who took my heart and has kept in this palm leaf? And he began to read repeatedly. In the meantime, Rup Goswami came and he did sastang pranam to Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu, like this, and he gave so many
blessings
on his back. Oh, how you knew all these things? I have not told to anyone. And at once, the Sarup Damodar was there, Raya Ramananda was there. Oh, to in whom heart you have inspired this, your mode? Oh, Valli Dekhanyo. So, we think that you are so merciful to sprinkle your mercy and your modes in this boy's heart, in Rupa Goswami's heart. So, anyone cannot do. Only by your mercy, to whom you will
inspired,
only he can know. Then Mahaprabhu told, oh, I have inspired something in prayer, but now I want that he may establish my whole
desires.
What I wanted. For I have descended from Golok Vrindavan, Shvetadeep. So you should be merciful. Oh Advaitachari, oh Haridas Thakur, oh Nityananda Prabhu, Sarvadamoda Rai Ranan, to all his devotees he requested that you should
sprinkle your mercy.
Why he did? Alone his mercy was not sufficient? Oh, no. Because he was of Vishaya mood. The subject,
object
of love.
Love and affection.
But Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, Sarbham Bhattacharya, all now?
Asraya.
Asraya. So, Asraya is of lakhs and lakhs moods. So all moods should come that he can realize, even what I can
realize.
And they all were very happy. And then he wrote one shloka about name. What part? Tunde Tandavani Ratavitunite Tundavali Lapta Karana Krono Karam Vini Ghatayate Karana Arbudeshashpiham Cheta Prangani Sarva Indriyanam Te Nirbhaktam Ka
Janita.
This is slope. And after that, oh, so many slopes. And it made what? Very wonderful thing. What is called nishtha? What is called shraddha? What is called bhav, rati? What is called prem, sneh, man, pranay, rag, anurag, bhav, mahama? He gave
all definition.
Like Srimad Bhagavatam, there is one shloka. Ete chans kalapunsa krishnastu
Bhagavan.
Like this. He made all definitions of from beginning to top. What is rati? Shuddha sattva visheshatma prema sujjansubha. What is prem? Mashanito swanta mamata atishankita
bhava
sandratma.
Oh,
all these things from top to bottom. If we will discuss all these things, or at least for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, then we can follow all these things. So try to pray Rupa Goswami. What? Adadana strenam dantairidam jache puna puna shimadarupadam bhojadholi shyad mama janmani janmani. Oh, why I want to be a dust of the lotus feet of Srila Rupa Goswami. Not only birth. Unlimited births. Even in this lok and also in Golok Vrindavan, they are what? The dust of Rukmanjari. Now time is over. I think that you should not repeat the history of Gita Sansar. Try to be careful. Very careful. Also one, I wanted to tell one story more. What? Kailash. The history of Kailash. We will discuss.
Alachwar.
Very good thing. We should play drama of
Kailash.
Now they should be ready. And very soon they should come.